Hey everyone, Marine here for Learn Fun, and I'm so glad to be back with a cute gingerbread house, which is also a candle decoration. This house was super easy to make, it just took some die cutting and a little bit of inking to create it. So I started by cutting the base using the shadow box card die set and paperback cardstock, and I went ahead and applied double-sided tape on the tabs. I set those elements aside and cut two house fronts out of craft cardstock using the Build a House die set. And to create a door opening and a window opening on those facades, I used dies from the Build a House Gingerbread House add-on. Obviously, I also needed walls, so I cut two rectangles measuring 3¼ by 2¾, and I used a die from Build a House to create window openings on those elements. Next, some texture, because my gingerbread house elements were definitely too flat. So I applied some vintage photo distress ink on the edges of my walls using a blending tool. I did it on the four elements, and to create like a cookie texture, I added drops of vintage photo. I smooshed my ink pad onto my glass surface, and I added water to create splatters on the four wall pieces. To hide the inside of the house and the candles, I attached pieces of vellum at the back of each wall. Doing this will also bring a nice diffuse lighting to the house. Next, I finally did the best part, which is decorating the four gingerbread walls. And to do this, I used dies from Build a House, from Build a House Christmas add-on, and from Build a House Gingerbread House add-on. The brown cardstock is paperback cardstock. I also used pixie dust cardstock to create the white icing. And to bring red to the house, I used a red shimmery cardstock and pattern papers from Snow Day Remix and let it shine. And using tweezers and a quick stick tool was definitely a great help with all those tiny pieces. At this point, I used the base element as a guide to attach the roof because I needed to line up the pointy ends of that roof with the top edge of the base. So the four walls are done, all the tiny pieces are attached, but before assembling those elements on the base, I needed to create holes to let the lights shine through the windows. And to do so, I marked the door and small window spots using a pencil, and I used the small square die from Build a House to cut openings out of the base elements. For the side walls, I marked the windows spots as well, and used the rectangle die to create the openings. I did the same thing on both pieces, and next I folded the score lines using a bone folder, and I assembled the gingerbread house base. Next, I used liquid glue to assemble everything on the base. The final step was to create a roof for my house, so I cut a rectangle out of red shimmery cardstock. This rectangle measures 3¾ by 3½, and I glued scallop details on top of it. And to add more sparkles to that roof, I cut a slightly bigger roof out of pixie dust cardstock, and I made the edges more interesting by using a scallop border die. Next, I glued the roofs, the white shiny one first, and then the red one on top. Next, I created two identical banners using a simple wavy border along with a sentiment from Winter Wavy Sayings. I white heat embossed my sentiment on a paperback banner, I attached that banner on a pixie dust one, and then I stuck the elements on each side of the house. Finally, I used a white gel pen to add highlights on some parts of the house, and I also applied glossy accents on the candy canes to make those elements super shiny. And that's it, my gingerbread house is done, and I think it would be fun to create more of these with different colors to create a cute village. So here's the house with all the lights around my desk on. And here's the house with the candles inside of it. I hope you like it and I will see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye!